Lucy, calm down.
I see something horrible. I'm afraid.
You're just having another nightmare.
Jonathan, this itching on the brain isn't good for you. It worries me.
Morning.
Harker, please come here.
Yes, Mr. Renfield.
I have a task for you. Something I don't dare trust to anyone else.
Oh, you're very kind, Mr. Renfield.
Count Dracula sent me a letter from Transylvania. He wants to buy a house here. Of course, it's an enormous trip to see him.
Where is that? Oh, the Carpathian Mountains, isn't it?
Yes. But on the other hand, there will be a large commission.
Oh, then I could get a nicer house for Lucy. She deserves a finer setting.
Yes. Well, this won't be easy. It may take you a long time. Cost you a lot of sweat. And possibly also a bit of blood.
Good to get out of the city for a while. get away from these canals, which go nowhere but back on themselves.
Transylvania. There, beyond the forests. A wonderful place. A little gloomy, but very exciting. The Count is just looking for a beautiful old house. I thought about the big one near your place.
But it's almost in ruins, been abandoned for years.
I'm sure he can make it into something cozy. Anyway, we'll offer it to him. You'll leave right now.
Right now? Today?
Certainly. I've got all the papers here. We mustn't make him wait.
All right, then. If it has to be today, it has to be. I'm ready.
Today? Right away?
Yes, to a castle in the Carpathians. It's a strange area where there are still a few wolves and people believe in ghosts.
Jonathan, I don't want you to go. I have this awful feeling.
That's ridiculous.
You'll be in danger. Don't go.
Wolves, robbers, and ghosts.
You mustn't leave like this. I cannot permit it. Let's at least spend some time first by the sea. We used to enjoy it so much.
Lucy, I don't know. Sometimes I'm so blind.
Jonathan, I have to say this. Even if you think it's foolish, coming from a feeble, unprotected home.
Yes?
I feel it like a force. An inner, nameless, deadly fear.
Lucy is the dearest thing in the world to me. Take care of her.
Of course.
Mina, treat her as a sister.
Yes.
Thank you. Innkeeper, quick, my supper. I have to go to the castle tonight.
Which one?
Count Dracula's.
Must you go there, really?
Yes. Why?
At midnight, all sorts of evil spirits are set loose. People disappear without a trace.
Oh, come on. That's all superstition.
You will not find a coach which will take you there. And your own horse needs care for several days.
I'll find another horse.
Don't go there, sir. The gypsies. Some of them have been on the other side. They know. He says you shouldn't go there, young man. He says on the way is a great chasm. It swallows the unwary. Then come towering crags. He says that the pass, the Borgo Pass, where the light suddenly divides and there, he says, the land rises upwards towards heaven and then falls to no one knows where.
Dicina na tu trnu musa, maja ode tu. Ano nebo ste džaha, onda ti šta huda tu tele.
Okine ja tu tele.
Doj ma sa otom odoj. A ode baro šišitno, vna dvike svojaka.
The gypsies have been saying that no such castle exists, except maybe in the imagination of men. It's just a ruin, they say, a ghost castle. A traveler who enters into that land of phantoms is lost and can never return.
Muszę sobie czytać książkę. Ciekawa, proszę, ciekawa. Ciekawa, nie, proszę. Ciekawa jest książka, proszę czytać.
For me?
Vampires. Let's see. Of vampires and bloodsuckers, of corpses which devour their own flesh, of incubuses and succubuses, of the living dead who follow strangers in the night, of werewolves, of milking of axes. That's a good one. Milking an axe of its blood. Makes men's bodies to quake and their teeth to chatter in their heads. Transylvania, Nosferatu, the undead, The curse will last until the end of time. The curse of the vampire Nosferatu. Coachman, could you take me to the Borgo Pass? I'll pay you well.
There is no road to the Borgo Pass.
But it's right there. I need your coach.
I haven't got a coach.
Could I have at least one of your horses? I'm willing to pay you double the price.
Sorry, sir. Can you not see? I haven't any horses.
Well, then I'll have to walk. Count Dracula.
Jonathan Harker. You have been expected and are welcome in my castle.
Thank you.
Come in. The night is cold and you must be tired and hungry.
These are the papers. The folded document contains the ground plan of the house, which I'm sure you will want to see.
Yes, yes. Please help yourself. Please. I'm afraid you must sup alone. It's nearly midnight, and I partake of nothing at this hour. Unfortunately, the servants are not at our disposal, either. So you allow me to see to your comfort. The children of the night make their music. Ah, young men, you are like the villagers who cannot place themselves in the soul of a hunter. The knife is old and could be dirty. It could give you blood poisoning. Please, let me do it. It's the oldest remedy in the world.
Oh, forget it. It's hardly worth mentioning. Just a little cut.
You know, it's only for the best. Let's sit up for a while. It's still many hours before dawn. And during the daytime, I am always away.
Lucy, my love, there is no postal service from here, but I shall write a diary, preserving all my thoughts and feelings for you. Last night, after a tiresome journey, I finally reached my destination, the castle of Count Dracula. I had a bad dream, but I hope it will pass. This castle is so strange, at times I wonder if it isn't part of that dream. Everything about it looks so unreal.
I don't attach importance to sunshine anymore, or to glittering fountains, which youth is so fond of. I love the darkness and the shadows, where I can be alone with my thoughts. I am the descendant of an old family. Time is an abyss. Profound as a thousand nights. Centuries come and go. To be unable to grow old is terrible. Death is not the worst. There are things more horrible than death. Can you imagine enduring centuries? Experiencing each day the same futile things.
I'm glad you found such a large old house for me, very near to your lodgings, I understand.
Yes, it's just around the corner.
May I have a look at the contract? A lovely throat.
It's my wife, Lucy. Your hand is so cold.
The documents, the contract for the house. I will send it immediately.
Yes, but we haven't settled the price.
It's a small matter between gentlemen. I accept whatever you find is just. How long did it take you to get here from Wismar?
4 weeks.
It takes a while on land.
From the seed of Belial is the vampire born. He who feeds on the blood of mankind, who unredeemed taketh his refuge in caves, tombs, coffins filled with the unblessed soil of cemeteries, wherein the Black Death hath reaped his harvest, the plague.
She's had a sudden fever. Call me at once if you think it is necessary. But I don't think it is really that serious.
Thank you.
going to Wismar. Lucy. Lucy's in danger. I've got to get out of here.
Strange, but the papers are all in order.
Let me see then. From Vana to Wismar, garden soil for botanical experiments.
Open one of them. I want to make sure.
Yes.
This one.
The patient we got yesterday is having a fit.
Which one?
The one who bit the cow. The one in solitary.
I'll come.
Blood is life.
Has he done this often before?
Yes, a few hours ago. Exactly the same thing. Instead of taking food,
He tries to eat flies.
That is nice.
Give it to me. Let go!
No letter again. But Lucy, you mustn't worry. Getting mail over the Carpathians is very difficult.
Something has happened to Jonathan. I know it.
Lucy, take comfort. The Lord will hear our prayers.
God is so far from us in the hour of distress.
Beskade potunarchite cestines. Maja nikai tu ach adai.
The young gentleman is quite ill. He must not travel yet.
The coffins. I must get to Wismar before the coffins.
The young gentleman should wait at least until the doctor comes tomorrow.
Yes, but Lucy is in danger. I have to save her. Coffins. Evil is on the way.
The ship seems burdened with a curse. Since we left the Caspian Sea, one after another, four mariners and the second mate have taken ill and gone to their rewards. One sailor and our cook have disappeared without a trace. A rumor circulated that there was a stranger on board. It terrified all. We searched, but there was nothing but the rats. We're true to our course, northwest at 30 degrees. Wind is steady, 12 knots this day.
Mr. Renfield, you ordered my husband to Transylvania. For weeks now, I have been without word from him. And I am sorely worried. I'm ready to set out to Transylvania myself.
Stay here. The master comes.
Who is coming? Tell us more.
The master of the rats. The army is hungry. And 400,000 strong. Transylvania, in the black seaport of Varna, the plague has appeared.
Thank you.
sorry, sir.
Hey, put a plank across. The ship must be fully checked.
Soul on board. Very little freight. And the hold is teeming with rats. But here's the log.
It is truly a mystery. Perchance, gentlemen, the ship's log may hold a clue to it.
Varna, 6 June. 5 hands, 2 mates, the cook and myself. Direction the Dardanelles. Course westward. Today the third man died of fever. Last night, the mate who had the watch disappeared without a trace. 20th June. Course northward. Sea high, making 40 knots towards Biscaya. Fear grows daily among the men. Only the first mate and I remain alive. Rats are everywhere. Could it be the plague?
The plague! Go home quietly, please. Shut the doors and windows. Gentlemen!
gracious lady. We're delivering this man, who seems to belong to this house.
Lucy! Jonathan!
Who is this woman?
Let's bring him in.
It must be a very severe brain fever.
The sun is hurting me.
Dr. Van Helsing, do you think it is possible that we are so insane that one day we will all wake to find ourselves in straight jackets?
You must excuse my rude entrance. I'm Count Dracula.
I know of you from Jonathan's diary. Since he has been with you, he's ruined.
He will not die.
Yes, he will. Death is overwhelming. Eventually, we all is. Stars spin and reel in confusion. Time passes in blindness. Rivers flow without knowing their course. Only death is cruelly sure.
Dying is cruelty against the unsuspecting.
But death is not everything. It's more cruel not to be able to die. I wish I could partake of the love which is between you and Jonathan.
Nothing in this world, not even God, can touch that. And it will not change, even if Jonathan never recognizes me again.
I could change everything. Will you come to me and be my ally? That be salvation for your husband and for me. The absence of love is the most abject pain.
Salvation comes from ourselves alone. And you may rest assured that even the unthinkable will not deter me. Good night. Nosferatu, the undead. He who drinketh the blood of his victims and turns them as well into phantoms of the night. He is as a shadow and hath no reflection. At night he penetrates through walls and doors. In shape of a bat he wafts into the chambers of the sleeping. In shape of a black wolf he hunts down those who flee. Abandon all hope. He whom he doth approach. And yet, though the vampire be an unnatural being, he must obey some natural laws. The sign of the cross bans him. A consecrated host can bar his retreat. And should a woman pure of heart make him forget the cry of the cock, the first light of day will destroy him.
What does the master command?
Go north to Riga. The army of rats and the Black Death are with you.
Oh. Thy will be done. Amen! Amen!
plague, the plague. What are you doing here?
I must go to the town council.
It's dissolved. It exists no more.
Then I have to see the mayor.
He's dead. Go home as quick as you can.
I know the reason for all this evil. I know the reason for all this. Why don't you listen? I know the reason.
Child, these are only the products of your imagination.
You have read Jonathan's diary. You see what has happened to him. It's getting worse here every day. The plague, the rats, and this book about the vampire. This book explains it.
We live in a most enlightened era. Superstitions such as you mentioned have been refuted by science.
I am absolutely certain this exists. I believe what I see with my own eyes.
Faith. Faith.
Faith, Dr. Van Helsing. Faith. Faith is the amazing faculty of man which enables us to believe things which we know to be untrue. You must come with me and help me to crush this monster. Coffins have come by boat from the Black Sea. If we can find where he has hidden them, we can destroy him. We can search for them tonight.
My child, you need some rest and relaxation. The affair with your husband has completely worn you out.
No, Dr. Van Helsing. Tonight.
This has got to be studied first, scientifically.
No, tonight. We mustn't lose a moment.
Even a farmer knows, my child, that everything has a proper time and sequence. He doesn't dig up the wheat to make sure it is growing. Only children playing at being farmers do something like that.
I see I'll have to do this alone.
Well, then.
Mother Superior, my medicine. My lady, how did I come to make your acquaintance?
Forgive me for what I do.
Join us, please.
It's our last supper.
We've all caught the plague. We must enjoy each day that's left.
Something terrible has happened. Are you all right? You're to come to the Schraders.
Calm down, Lucy. You can come closer. It is certainly not the plague.
My God. What has happened?
We don't know exactly. Except that this morning, Shraddha found Mina dead. We took him to hospital. We still have no explanation. The causes will be gone into with scientific thoroughness, leaving aside superstition and prejudice. The plague, we can most certainly rule that out.
I know now what I have to do. The consecrated host bans the vampire. And should a woman pure of heart make him forget the cry of the cock, the first light of day will destroy him.
Now I know. Oh, God, that I had listened to her before. A stake and a hammer, quickly. I have to dispatch this fiend forever.
Stop. Don't do it. Van Helsing, get him! Yes, him! Seize him! That man has murdered the Count.
Have you done that? With that stake there?
Yes. But there was an urgent reason for doing it.
That's for the court to decide. You're under arrest, Dr. Van Helsing. Arrest this man.
Arrest? You're asking me to arrest him?
Yes.
I've never made an arrest.
Then go and get the police.
They're dead and gone.
Then take the man to prison.
There's no one there to guard him anymore.
Then you must arrest him yourself. After all, you're a town employee.
Then how should I do it? I need arms for it.
Go on, get on with it.
I can't, I'm unarmed.
Nevertheless, you'll arrest this man.
Well, where will you take me then?
I'm wondering myself. To the prison, I think.
What are you doing standing there? Fetch your broom. Can't you see? Everything here is full of dust. Seal the bedroom for the official investigation and bring me my horse. I have much to do now.